Hello. Welcome to Fitting Free with me. I can't see without my glasses. Hi, I'm Angel. I'll leave them off for a little bit while I see if I can look that way and introduce myself again today. As usual, I'm here just trying to keep myself on track, check in with my body, do a little bit of strengthening and stretching, and invite you to join me to whatever degree feels good in your body. I've been staccatoing it up, as I say, and I am still working on this list, which might look familiar by now if you're part of my regular crew. Even though it's backwards, maybe you're starting to be able to read it. I'm working on my level one yoga instructor certification and trying to practice my Sanskrit names because they are still elusive to me. So I will be doing that, and I'm probably going to put on my sunglasses so I can see those. I'm going to take off my shoes while I give you a quick overview of what we'll be doing today, which is a very similar series that I've been doing for the last little while, which is a series I've picked out for digestive health specifically. Been dealing with some gut issues myself, some prolapse, some inflammation, some indigestion, some irritability. And so I've picked out a series of six poses, and sometimes I add one or two in transition. Sometimes I remove one. In fact, the bridge pose that's in here, I may have to find a substitution. But what I have on my board still is cat-cow or Marjariasana and Bittulasana, which is a nice sequence that goes together, a pair that goes very well together. I have downward facing dog or Adho Mukha. I have extended puppy pose, which is similar to that, but for me a little bit more challenging. Uttana Shishosana is the Sanskrit word for that. I have a restful pose, child's pose, Balasana, and another sort of in between restful and active pose, supine twist, or I'm gonna have to put these on to read my writing, Setu Bandha Saranvan Asana. I think that's all of them. I read them out of order. Again, this is a series I've picked out specifically for digestive health and for sitting down here on the floor or fitting into this camera scenario, which it's a good time to remind you, you don't have to wear any special outfit. I got my work clothes on today because I'm going to go over and do some pruning and painting at my mom's house after this. Starting in tabletop position with a relatively flat back. Energy going out the top of the head and out the spine, tailbone. And then I'm going to get into some breath and just play around with that. But first, just to talk you through it, the cat position or Marjariasana is I tend to need to pull forward a little bit, trying to really round the spine, pushing up through those shoulders, rounding the spine both front to back and side to side, and keeping those knees under the hips and the hands under the shoulders, and tucking the chin into the chest, looking in toward the navel, pulling in with the navel and tucking the tailbone under. Marjariasana. And then Bittulasana. Pushing still up in the shoulders, but now lifting the head, lifting the tailbone, both toward the sky or towards each other. Trying to still keep active in the tummy. I tend to want to like sag down, but ideally don't quite sag down so much, although sometimes it feels good to just release that. But again, an opposite arching of the back, eyes lifted. And then with the breath, now I'm going to do a few of those.
couple more. Really squeezing out the air in the lungs, pulling up through the body, pushing up through the arms. And then we come back to tabletop, tuck these toes under and come into downward facing dog or Adho Mukha. Pressing through the palms into those heels. I'm gonna alternate bending the right leg, pushing into the left heel. Bending the left leg, pushing into the right heel. Alternating those again, just getting a nice stretch. I missed my minimums yesterday and I'm feeling it. Pushing back into both heels. Fingers are wide, palms are strong and firm on the ground. Pushing back through those hips, back into the heels. And then I'm going to come down into that extended puppy pose, bending the knees, keeping about a 90 degree angle, keeping my hips over my knees and gaining some stability there in my my knees to my hips, and then sliding my fingers out. And that's Uttana Shishosana. I'm gonna look out at my fingertips, or you can look down at the ground, keeping the head in line, ears next to elbows. That feels good for me in the shoulders. And from there, I'm going to come back up to on the knees and bring my hands to my heels for a little bit of that bridge pose. I'm taking it easy on my arms. So I may come out of this quickly and I'm going to kind of come up on the fingertips there to not torque them. This is Setu Bandha Saranvang Asana. Looking forward, pushing the hips forward. Squeezing the butt cheeks together. And releasing that. Coming back and folding up into child's pose. Bringing the forehead down toward the ground. Arms back to the sides and behind the body. Pull my glasses out of the way and just turn the head to one side. And relax here in child's pose or balasana for a few breaths. Give you permission to sigh. Just release whatever's no longer serving you. Check in with your body. Let go of tension anywhere that it's built up. Sometimes it helps to rock a little bit or jiggle a little bit. That's fine. You do whatever works good for your body. And then coming back up, I'm going to sit down and roll over onto the back for a supine twist. I'm gonna start with both knees bent today, giving myself a nice hug and a little bit of rocking back and forth here. I like to massage the back a little bit and check in. I'm actually gonna extend the legs and arms and hook my heels onto the floor. See if I can show you that a little bit. And then I'm just rocking, flapping my feet sort of, and jiggling my whole body, seeing if I can feel that through the whole spine, and just relax, jiggling, and letting things align. It's a nice, relaxing movement. Again, just giving myself a little release. Give you permission to sigh as you wish. And then I'm gonna bring that low back onto the floor. Keep your hands under that tailbone if you're feeling like you need extra support. I'm gonna bring both knees up to the chest again, and then bring them out to about a 90 degree angle here, pressing the low back onto the floor. You can keep hands to the sides or up high. I'm gonna keep them up here under my head, and trying to keep both knees together today for a supine twist to the left. Just gonna keep the torso straight upwards. You could increase that twist by looking to the right, and I guess I'll turn my head to the right, but I'm gonna keep my arms there and just relax into that supine twist. Let me check the name. Supta Matsyendra Asana. And then I'm gonna lift those knees, coming back to center, and looking to the left, putting the knees to the right. Nice. Supta Matsyendra Asana. To the right, looking to the left. Gives the organs a nice little hug, the spine a nice twist, nice little squeeze through the midsection. Let's come back to center and do that one more time on both sides. Coming over, knees to the left, looking to the right. Relaxing there, both knees together, up to the center, and then looking to the left, knees coming to the right. You can vary this up quite a bit by straightening the lower leg if you wish. I'll do that just for good measure on this side real quick. That deepens the twist a little bit, but lessens the abdominal work. I'm gonna just give myself another hug here, just letting the low back relax, give that a nice little jiggle. And let's come back into that corpse pose. Arms, hands facing, palms up. Just relaxing for a few breaths here. Checking in with the body. Still just letting go of stress, letting go of whatever I no longer need, whatever no longer serves me. Checking in with my body with a little bit of gratitude. It's kind of scanning from the toes, through the feet, through the ankles, through the calves and the knees and the thighs, the pelvis, and the belly, and the diaphragm, the lungs and the heart. And I forgot to check in with all those digestive organs. Let's go back, spend an extra moment there, just releasing, relaxing. Back to a little clockwise, depending on how you're looking at it. From the top will be clockwise, circle, and really help. I've been trying to remember to do that at least a couple times a day. Just check in with the belly, check in with the digestion, just check in with the lungs and the heart, the throat and the arms, and the face and the head. Just relaxing, letting go. Thank you for stopping in and checking in with me and with you today.
Thanks for being yourself and letting me be myself. Like to remind you to stay curious, stay courageous, stay fit, and stay free. Ciao for now.